This is NBC 10 News.
Well, tonight there are major developments in the Penn State child sex abuse scandal.
Former coach Jerry Sandusky scores several legal victories from the judge. NBC 10's Luann Kahn is joining us now with the details. Luann?
Right, you know, Jerry Sandusky wanted a local jury. And it looks like he's going to get that. And apparently the judge didn't think much about all that fuss about him standing on his back porch watching kids. Sandusky made the request for a local jury on Friday. Prosecutors argued it will be difficult to pick a fair and impartial jury from the community. But the judge ruled he wants to give this a try. Sandusky's been under house arrest while awaiting trial on charges he molested 10 boys over a 15-year period. The judge ruled that Sandusky can now have visits from his grandchildren, except for three involved in a custody dispute. He's leaving that decision to another judge. Prosecutors also wanted Sandusky off his back porch. Now, you remember, neighbors complained and videotaped him on his deck feeding the dog and watching children play, but the judge ruled there is no evidence that he's a threat. Sandusky's lawyer says his client is pleased by today's ruling. But the judge also decided Sandusky will not get as much information about his accusers as he wants. Local attorney Tom Klein says that's a win for his client, one of the alleged victims.
Those aren't mind-boggling and surprising rulings by a judge who basically has this man under house arrest. To say that he can go on his porch is no earth-shattering news. The real rulings that counted are those rulings that had to do with where is venue going to be. Venue is going to be in Center County, but only provisionally. What Mr. Sandusky and his lawyers are entitled to, only a narrow band of information. Those are the key rulings that we as lawyers look to say what really happened here today.
Sandusky maintains his innocence. So does former Penn State Administrator Tim Curley. He filed a motion in court today asking that the perjury charge against him be dropped. The late Joe Paterno would have been a key witness in that case. Luann Kahn, NBC 10 News.
All right, thank you, Luann.